Full disclaimer, this is not a how-to video. This product is not approved by the U.S. Coast Guard. This product is not even a copy of something approved by the U.S. Coast Guard. It is merely an idea that I came up with and put together. Like it or not, this is my idea.
Well, I do apologize. I will be the narrator for this entire video, thanks to copyright laws. Yes. Well, what I'm talking about here is my new Canon camera. Yep, that's the Canon Exiva. I'm loving this thing. I got the wide angle lens on it. Got the microphone for it. There's a light on it. Boy, it's really good to go. And then my son Christopher, he picked me up the GoPro Hero 8. Boy, what a great camera this is. Another wonderful Oregon sunny day, right? Yeah, okay. So let's build a canoe seat. So I tripped on down to my local store, Empire Mercantile, great place. Picked up that used seatbelt material. Went over to the boat shop and I found this great bumper line. It's actually for big yachts, you know, you put your nice fancy bumpers on. But what's great about it, it's the same kind of rope I was going to buy to put on for a bow line. But it's got this great sewn-in loop in it. You know, that's, man, for a dollar less. Can't believe it. So it's pretty nice. Got some extra hardware here, some hinges, some pads, some staples, some good old boiled linseed oil to finish it all off. Can't have nothing rotten. Stainless steel screws, and of course, some more seatbelt material. Boy, I overbought that stuff. And from the scrap pile, a couple of pieces of oak board salvaged from an old waterbed frame I got for free on Craigslist about a year ago.
Regret to say that my table saw here just burned out in the middle of cutting this board, and I didn't even get it on camera. Well, brand new camera, still learning how to use it. Anyway, my table saw is burned out. It sucks, so I'm gonna have to try to rip these in a different way. We'll see how it goes.
Measure twice, cut once, build a jig, cut a bunch. That's what I always say. So this is what I had to do in lieu of my table saw. Rip these things with my circular saw. Notice how close that blade is to that metal bed, boy. It was kind of rough, but I got her done.
I don't know why I'm still alone, believing something could become of me. Thinking about it constantly, afraid that it's a part of me. I dream of my success just like the rest, and if I'm best, then I'm the best. I put it off the life I'm wishing. Don't know what to do, I can't catch a break. All of my trials, I'll bet on mistakes. Try to compete, but I don't run. I hate that I'm rushing like everyone. I feel like a loser, I know that I'm great. All my
Alright, so here I'm grading my lumber. So I've got the most strongest pieces, the less strongest pieces, and the least strongest pieces. All consider those when I'm doing my build. I'll make sure I use the strongest ones there for my main supports, and the rest can be from my lateral supports. Now that I've got all the pieces cut, I'll start putting the frame together. I know there are no limits in my mind. I'll do my best, I won't give up. I'll take my chances, beat the luck. I'm gonna show you, so just wait and see. No one can handle this fight. Got the blood of a tiger. A few more fine-tune adjustments. I'm using a router here so I can make sure I keep all the edges nice and round, nice and skin friendly. Also countersinking all the screws, using nothing but case hardened screws here. This way my big butt won't break them. I will say the one biggest drawback of using the yoke is that I probably added 20 pounds to my boat just in this seat alone. This, I say, was the most difficult part of the whole project. My sawzall took a dump here in the middle, lost battery power, had to break out the old Japanese wood saw. But you know what? It was kind of fun hand carving everything out, making it just right. It kind of really brought the personality into the seat. Kind of makes me more attached to it now. I've really busted my butt trying to get it nice, and it really came out nice. And really in doing it, it gave me kind of a desire to really build a really fancy seat where I really do a lot of carving, but maybe another time. We'll see how well this one works. Here I'm explaining the difference in the sides. One side's much thicker than the other. This way it's got a nice taper. This way it'll fit on my back real comfortable. This cut here was the most critical. It's a slight angle just so it rests good against the backrest, so the whole thing ends up at the perfect pitch for my back. So it's not a straight up and down seat. It's just got the nice slope on the back. I don't know what exact angle this is. I kind of just stuck my pieces in the boat and figured out this is how I want to be. And then I ended up having to cut this little flat section on the end there. It's pretty difficult. Ended up with a lot of knots and things in the wood. That's why I kept breaking there. But all in all, it came out pretty flat on the last little tip and gave my seat a lot more strength and being able to do it with the two angles like that. I'm using a router here so I can make sure I keep all the edges nice and round, nice and skin friendly. These chrome plated marine grade hinges weren't very cheap, but they sure are nice. Here's a good look at that finished product on that edge. Nice and rounded. Real comfortable feeling. Now remember, this is going to be all wrapped in seatbelt material anyways, but came out pretty good, I think. This is kind of my favorite part of this whole process. I don't know, I just love weaving things. But put a couple staples in it. Took me a little bit to figure it out the first time. Wasn't sure how to get it all going the way it was going to work the best. And the two pieces on the ends have those extra supports, so they're a little more tricky. So then I decided the best thing to do was just take out a candle and start melting these edges and cut me up a whole bunch of the right sizes. So this way I got them all ready to go. And just keep on moving along, put them all right next to each other, then flip it over and start going the other way, in and out on one another. And as you do this, the whole thing gets tighter and tighter. Voila, there's my seat back. All weaved together, real nice and tight. Seatbelt material really worked well for this. I really wanted to use some kind of nylon, but this actually works really well. I like the color, and for 20 cents a foot, boy, you can't go wrong. Go colorblind. Now I'm finishing up the bottom, coming together really tight, real nice, all nice and square. This part was pretty easy. Now the hinges for the finishing touch, and voila, there's a seat. You could use it just like it is right now. It would just keep sliding around like my little lawn chair did. So time to figure out just where it needs to be mounted. I have some spots that I actually drew into the bottom with a Sharpie that when I took the boat out, so I knew where my weight would be. Yeah, this is all right. Regrettably, I didn't film the mounting brackets in detail. They were probably just as difficult as carving out that backside, really a lot more difficult as far as the math goes. If you could imagine, the bottom of the canoe is rounded and the edge of the canoe is tapered. So consequently, when you have this 2x6, I had to carve out the bottom round by adding an angle to one side of it to make it deal with the slope and taper of the canoe, and at the same time being able to mount that to a square seat. So if you could imagine, the angles were pretty dynamic in that. So here we are, all done. It was a fun project, got it all together, and there's the seat. I even added a cup holder, took two of those cheapies, put them together for strength, screwed it in, came out pretty good. I like that part of it. Also added this cool little spot right here. And this bungee cord is actually to hold the seat down, but I think if I stick it right here, I can probably hold my water bottle in there too. So kind of dual purpose on that one. So as the seat goes back, you can see it's on a hinge, so it kind of folds forward and back nice and easily. Then I installed this big thwart, and it's got two rod holders in there. Kind of overkill, but you know, hey, I'm a big guy. Gives me lots of room underneath to store stuff. If you kind of look at the seat there, you notice it's just kind of floating. It's sitting on those rubber pads. The only place it's really connected is on those two screws that are near the front there, as you can see right there. Holds on really well. Can't believe how sturdy it is. Of course, like I said, those angles really help out. Then I decided to make this bolt-on camera mount as well. Got some thumb screws on the bottom to hold it together. I put this cool little bungee on here. I got two stages for this. If I'm in white water, boat flips over and a big rock comes along and hits this, it'll stay down. And then if I decide that I want to go and just leave it on there and not take it back off, I can actually bungee this in place for transport, which is most likely what my lazy butt will do. Here's a little close-up there on the little eyelet that the bungee goes into just to hold it in place. A little shot of the thumb screw there. As you can see, it holds it down nice and tight. Good for transport. And speaking of transport, let's go ahead and take that seat, throw it down. And I used a little cool trick here that I saw in another YouTube video where I heated up a piece of pipe and actually stuck it on that nylon, burned a round hole, and then drilled my hole in the center for that bungee. Came out really good. So all tied up, ready to go. Here's my bow line installed. Really nice. I just can't believe that cost me a dollar less than just buying the rope bare. But I tell you, you know, manufacturing, people think that kitting is a bad thing, but I don't think so. Sometimes you can use a kit for something different and end up with a nice braided line, just like this one. All in all, this took about a day and a half. It was a fun project, and I can't wait to get her on the water.
Thank you all so much for watching. I really appreciate your support. This channel's really taken off here in the last couple months. Maybe everybody's at home, have COVID, and there's nothing else better to do, but hopefully that I'm finally getting out there, putting the right tags and letting people see the things that I'm doing. If you guys appreciate the things I'm doing, then please hit that subscribe button. I can't believe it. As of right now, I'm at 220 subscribers. You know, a lot of people say, well, that's nothing, Chuck. Yeah, well, I put this together just so my family can see what I'm doing that lives in other states. and see how wonderful it here is in wonderful Oregon. And it just tickles me to pink to see that I have followers that are in Canada and farther away than that, some in the Middle East. It's pretty awesome. And I think it's fantastic, and I thank you so much for the opportunity just to get in front of you and do what I do. So if you have any suggestions or things you'd like me to see or like me to do or you'd like to see, then let me know in the comments below. I'd really love to see it. I'm kind of into everything outdoors, and I haven't done any climbing videos and things like that in a while because it's been pretty rainy and wet and not a lot of opportunity around here. God bless. Hope you enjoy this idea for this canoe seat. Take care.